So what I have here is a Lenovo M900, and I think it's either a slim, tiny, ultra-small form factor. I'm not sure what Lenovo calls these, but it's an ultra-small form factor PC. And it was given to me. It works just fine. The thing is, I needed to have two NICs, and it only has one. Now, this does come with a wireless card, usually. Not this one, but this model usually comes with it. And that's what that hole is for, and it looks like there was an antenna in there at some point, and it's been removed. However, the M.2 slot that it uses the wireless card, according to Lenovo, can only be used for wireless. It cannot support anything else, including an Ethernet card. However, I have one. It's an M.2, and I think this is an Intel, I forget what the chipset is. I forget the chipset exactly offhand, I don't have it on me at the moment, but yeah, it's an M.2. I think it's a 2.5, and some people say these things work great in here. Other people say they do not work at all. So it could just be different cards, or it could be different BIOS revisions, or different revisions of the board. But we're going to give it a shot in this and see if it works. And if it does work, do we get good throughput, or is it going to be kind of limited? So let's find out. So first up, let's just open it up. Like I said, this thing, I have tested it. It does work. Currently, Windows 10 is installed on it, and we'll use that to do the testing. The reason I'm doing this, though, is because I am going to be using this for a router. The current router I have uses an Atom D510, I believe it's called, board. And I don't want to say it's working good, because it's not. It worked good, but the board is getting old. It's been in a basement, so it's been in damp areas, and the board, you can just do this and all kinds of crumb comes off of it. So I probably clean the board, it would be fine, but I figure, you know what, it's time to upgrade that thing. So here's the slot that this is going to go into, and then this should fit where the serial port is. So we're going to take the serial port out and try to put that in its place, and we're going to put this in, and hopefully that fits. Now I don't have no screw. Oh, here we go. Came with some screws. So hopefully that'll fit. If not, I'll find something. Actually, you know what? Before I do that, let's get this out of here. And I don't have a socket on me. We'll just use this. All we gotta do is just loosen it a little bit and come right off. Should come right out here. It should, theoretically. Come on. There you go. All right. So let's pull that off the board. Let's put that there. Let's pop this in. Okay. I found the screw. It's actually a Torx head, and it's got a nut on there as a washer. It's a little bit too long, but don't look pretty, but who cares? I'm not going to be looking at it. But yeah, so I currently have... I'm using PF Sense. I really like it. It's done well. And some people might say, you know, why not you just use, you know, go get yourself a Netgear or Linksys router. Well, I have in the past, but I just like the flexibility of these, well, it's OpenBSD. I was going to say Linux distros, but it's actually OpenBSD. And that's just what I want to do. So let's see, is this going to fit? I might have to put some tape down so it doesn't short out, if it even fits in here. I think that'll work. I'm just going to put some tape down just because I don't want these contacts shorting out on anything. All right, so you can just see I put some black electrical tape down there. Again, ain't the prettiest thing in the world, but who's going to be seeing it? It's just a router. At least that's the plan anyway. And also down here, they're not too sharp, so I think it'll be okay. Just going to slide that in there. Now the question is going to be, is this hard drive caddy going to work with it? If not, I have some solutions for that, but I want to see if this thing, at least if it boots and detects it. Is this going to be... Let me get a cable, make sure it fits through there, because we may have to take this all apart and just kind of nudge that out a little bit. Right, let me put that in before I totally tighten it down. Oh yeah, it's perfect. And I'm putting it in the wrong one. What am I doing? It didn't... Did I do that before? Did I put it in the wrong... Oh. All right. Fits. So we're gonna, while it's in there, I'm gonna tighten it down while it's in there, just to hold it in place. Okay, pull that out. All right, I think it looks pretty good. We got two NICs, and if this thing works, it has good throughput. Now, this is just a modem, and it's a cable modem, and we don't have very good internet service out here. So I mean, a little over 100 meg would be in good shape, because I think we only have 120, or what works out to be 120. Alright, so that fits. And before I put this, I am going to take this off and actually put new thermal paste and everything. I just want to see if this works for, or if this works with this first. You stay there. All right. All right, it's turning on. We have no signal to the monitor. And it turned off. Now, the thing is, this is a router, so it turned back on. Is it not liking that card? Or is it just doing a diagnostic thing? Oh, we got something. All right, cool. Let's see. All right, so it does say Ethernet controller right there. Actually, it says a lot of stuff, so I need lots of drivers. This didn't do a full install, which is fine. All right, so I'm going to let that roll. Just let them download. We'll see if it detects it, and then I'll hook it up to... I have another laptop here. We'll make sure it can actually get a link, and we'll... you know, test the speed. That was a bit more trouble than I expected for just a quick test. Since this is a cheap Chinesium board, the Intel drivers only seem to work up to 28.2. Anything above that gives a certificate error. Now, everyone on forums says to just install 28.2, which I did. Well, 28.0, because that's all I could find. This, again, is only for a test, so I don't really care. I just want to see if the card and the board can give decent throughput. First, I'll set static IPs for both the onboard and the added NIC. I'm going to be connecting this directly to my laptop, which has a gigabit NIC. I could run iPerf and get all into it, but I just want to see, you know, the throughput in copying a file and see how it compares to the onboard NIC. First, the onboard NIC, and copying from my laptop, it looks like it's averaging around 112 megabytes per second, and that's about 900 megabit. Now, the add-on card. And it seems to be doing the same. No bottleneck here. At least, again, at gigabit speeds. And that's all I really need it for. So that's about as high as I'll be testing. And in case you're wondering, yes, I did go and replace the thermal paste while I had it all apart. The stuff that was in it was probably what it came with originally, because it was a bit dry. Some may be asking what I'm using for paste. This is Protronix Series 9. I'm not saying it's the greatest because, well, it's not. But it serves its purpose, and really, it's cheap. I've had pretty good luck with it. I actually think their Series 7 performed a bit better, but regardless, it works, and I haven't had any issues. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and install pfSense and get that all set up. I'll probably make a video if the Atom board still works. Maybe we'll throw a GPU on it and see how it compares against a Pentium 4 or something. But anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.